everyone. This is Wolfram of the Traveler's Well Astrology, and it's eclipse season, which means it's a time of excitement, and there's all kinds of fun things going on. And what we want to do today is share a few minutes of thoughts so that you can understand what an eclipse is, what it has to do with you, and the kind of magic that it brings into your life. So what does a solar eclipse do? How do you feel it? A solar eclipse is like a burst of energy which gets suddenly injected into your life and to the experiences that you have in life that have a tendency to affect your life for about 6 to 8 months, slightly before and then moving beyond the timing of the solar eclipse. The way that I like to think about a solar eclipse is with an image. Imagine that you're on the yellow brick road in the Land of Oz, and you're riding your bicycle. And what happens is the solar eclipse is like a sudden push from the hand of the divine that projects you forward. Now, with any eclipse, if you could imagine this, there are two possible outcomes to this injection of energy. If you are prepared, meaning if you have been taking action towards your goals, if you have been making efforts that allow you to develop momentum, suddenly you'll find that your journey is energized and, in a sense, you speed up. So when there's a solar eclipse that hits your chart in a powerful way and things suddenly start moving forward, you're following your yellow brick road. Now, sometimes in life, we have a tendency to get lost. We get off track somehow. Imagine that you're on the yellow brick road and you look out of the corner of your eye and you see the Emerald City and you kind of take a sidetrack. And you don't really recognize it, but all of a sudden you're in the middle of the poppy patch. When the eclipse hits you during this time, the bike will start wobbling and maybe it'll even fall over. There tends to be a little bit of a crisis of one kind or another. The intention of both of these events, the speeding up if you're on the yellow brick road, and the falling over, the crisis if you're in the poppy patch, are connected to the same theme. Your soul has a plan, and the eclipse is meant to either speed you up on your goals, or if you're lost a little bit, to let you know so that you can get back on track. Each and every solar eclipse will fall into your birth chart somewhere. And the most obvious way that this can happen is the eclipse will fall into a particular house. Here's a list of the houses, and what's important is that the theme that is connected to the house is often the theme that is energized by the solar eclipse. Now, for this eclipse, on the 21st of August, 2017, the sun is at 28 degrees of Leo. So for everybody who's born between August 16th and 25th, no matter what year, this solar eclipse will directly impact your sun. In this case, there are three keys to what the sun wants and that are going to be energized by the eclipse. Number one, know thyself, to know what is true for the core of you, what makes you shine, and to make sure that you're following and energizing that aspect. Second, to take confident action, in a sense, to have the willpower and focus to make decisions so that you can take action. And third, of course, the sun wants you to shine. It wants you to take what's most radiant in you and to push that out into life, to share yourself with life. This solar eclipse is going to speed up that process, finding your purpose, injecting the energy to know thyself, to be confident, and to take action and shine. And if something is off track, the solar eclipse might create a disruption that will, in a sense, let you know what's not working. For people born between roughly 1958 and 1959, the solar eclipse will impact the Pluto in your birth chart. For these people, we'll all have Pluto in the sign of Leo. In In this case, this Pluto in Leo talks about deeply ingrained karma, your greatest gifts, your capacity for courage, and the confidence that's required to take action. But also embedded in this Pluto is the fear of not being accepted, not being recognized, and as a result, sometimes not being confident. This is old karmic material, and for many of us, this Pluto, this solar eclipse, will energize this karmic material, promoting the process of releasing this old material from the past, of embracing the potential to be healed, and in the process, to embrace a grand new chapter of your life. For many of us, this will mean that it's not about what we do, but not only doing that, but sharing it with the right audience. So in one degree, the degree to which you can identify your kindred spirits, this will really greatly help because these are the people that resonate in harmony with you and who share your perspective on life, and they're the ones that are waiting for you to share what is important in you. They want you to shine. No matter what, this eclipse will be energizing for people with Pluto in Leo from 54 to 59 to energize broad, sweeping evolution, to make progress, to embrace transformation. So, this eclipse is pointing the way to the future. Remember, the soul has a purpose. Between October of 1960 and July of 63, if you were born during this time, the solar eclipse will impact your Uranus. Uranus in Leo in the birth chart contains a deep desire to be honored and to be creative, in particularly in the way that is unique to you. These people really need their uniqueness to be accepted. They need to be appreciated for these unique qualities. And this is once again where the role of kindred spirits comes in. You're here to share what is important with this group of people. Now, with the eclipse hitting, if the eclipse is hitting the Uranus in your chart, there are two key words: awakening and liberation. This eclipse may awaken the keys to your uniqueness and to those kindred spirits that are looking for you. Additionally, it may liberate you from the circumstances and people that hold you back, that keep you feeling like you need to be inauthentic. Finally, between August of 48, if you were born between August of 1948 and July of 49, and again between September of 77 and August of 78, you have Saturn in the sign of Leo being impacted by this eclipse. Saturn's the lord of karma, and here in the sign of Leo, Saturn is attempting to remind you that there's something about your individuality, your creativity, your deepest gifts that have not been brought into material expression. They need to be finished. This eclipse is here to help you to recognize, A, what you need to do, and second, to let go of any limiting beliefs that have been unconsciously holding you back. One of my favorite quotes is from Sri Swami Rama of the Himalayas, who said, "You are the architect of your life, and you decide your destiny." This is at the heart of what Saturn in Leo is all about. So, take action, let go of the beliefs that limit you, trust yourself. For everybody, this eclipse is one that is going to accelerate your path moving forward. I hope you're on the yellow brick road and you feel life speed up. At the same time, if you find that you are have a little bit of a crisis because you've been lost in the poppy patch, don't worry about that. Get up, get back on the yellow brick road, and move forward. In all cases, your soul has a plan, and the eclipse is energizing that plan.
Thanks for listening, and may you move in harmony with the sun, moon, and stars. Namaste.